Welcome to the Blazor Data Grid tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to bind data from a RESTful web service to the Syncfusion Blazor Data Grid component. First, let me open an existing Blazor web app in auto mode. If you want to learn how to create a Blazor web app with auto mode selection, check out the video linked in the YouTube card above. Now I will demonstrate how to create the relational database using SQL Server for storing our data. Choose the SQL Server Object Explorer option under View menu. Right-click on the Databases folder and create a new database and name it Order Details. Expand the created database. Right-click on the Tables folder and click Add New Table. In the Design window, create a table named Orders and add the necessary columns along with their respective data types. Notice that the orders table is rendered based on a query. Click the Update button and subsequently click Update Database. The Order Details database is successfully updated. Next, I will demonstrate how to create the OData Service project to connect to the database and expose the data. First, I right-click on the project solution and click Create a New Project. Then search ASP.NET Application and select the empty ASP.NET Core Web Application and name it OData Service Project. Notice that I am using .NET 8 framework for this project. And click Create button to create the project. See, the OData Service Project is created. After creating the project, install the necessary Microsoft NuGet packages to connect the database and expose the data. Right-click on the Dependencies section and select Manage NuGet Packages. Switch to the Browse tab, search for Microsoft ASP.NET Core OData, and install this package. This package contains everything you need to create OData v4 endpoints using ASP.NET Core MVC and supports OData query syntax for your web APIs. Next, to perform scaffolding and work with the SQL Server database in our application, search for Microsoft Entity Framework Core Tools and install this package. This package creates database context and mono classes from the database. Also, search for and install the Microsoft Entity Framework Core SQL Server package, which is the database provider that allows Entity Framework Core to work with SQL Server. Also, ensure that the Microsoft Entity Framework Core design package is already installed in the server project dependencies. This package includes capabilities such as reverse engineering, scaffolding, and migration management. Additionally, right-click on the dependencies and select Add Project Reference to enable the OData Service project. This ensures that any changes or updates in the OData Service project are reflected in the main project, facilitating easier management and maintenance of dependencies. Once the packages are installed, run the scaffold db context command in the package manager console. This command will generate the db context and mono classes for the existing database and its tables using details such as the connection string, data provider, and output directory. To do this, open the package manager console, change the default project to OData Service Project, and run the scaffold db context command. After running the command, the order details context.cs and order.cs files will be created under the OData Service Project Models folder. You can see that the order details context.cs file contains the connection string details in the onConfiguring method. It is not recommended to have a connection string with sensitive information in the order details context.cs file, so I comment this method. Open the app settings JSON file within the OData Service project and add the connection string within this file. Next, open the program CS file, configure the connection string and register it as a scoped service using the addDBContext method. Next, I will show you how to create an OData v4 service. The application is now configured to connect with the Order Details database using Entity Framework. Now, it's time to consume data from the Order Details database. To do so, I need an OData controller to serve data from the DB context to the Blazor application. First, create the controller folder within the OData service project. Within the folder, create a class named OrdersController. After creating the OrdersController class, add the Microsoft ASP.NET Core Data Routing Controller's namespace and inherit the OdataController class. This class provides OData's specific routing and query handling for ASP.NET Core applications. Inside this class, create a private field named DB of type order details context to store the database context. Then create the constructor for orders controller that takes an order details context object as a parameter. Within the constructor, assign the order details context object passed as a parameter to the DB field. Next, I will create the get method. First, add the HTTP get attribute. This attribute specifies that this method handles HTTP GET requests. Then add the enable query attribute to enable OData query support for this action method. Now, create the action method that returns IAction result. Inside this method, return an HTTP OK response with a list of orders from the DB orders database context. Next, I open a program CS file in the OData service project. First, I create the getEDMModel method. This static method sets up the entity data model PDM for OData. It uses OData convention model builder to define an entity set for orders. The myFirstFunction method is defined on the orders collection, returning a collection of orders. Finally, getEDMModel returns the configured EDM model. Following that, I register the controllers with a dependency injection container, making controller services available throughout the application. Afterwards, I add OData functionality to the controllers. Add OData configures OData endpoints with the route OData using the EDM model defined in getEDMModel method. It also enables various OData query options like count, filter, order by, expand, and select. Moreover, I configure cross-origin resource sharing to allow requests from any origin method and header. This is necessary for a Blazor web app to make requests to the API from the client side. Additionally, I add middleware to redirect HTTP requests to HTTPS, enhancing security, and apply the CORS policy defined earlier, allowing cross-origin requests. Furthermore, I add the authorization middleware to the request pipeline, ensuring that only authorized requests can access the API endpoints. Finally, I set map controller endpoints to the request pipeline, enabling the application to route requests to the appropriate controllers. Next, I will demonstrate how to add the Syncfusion Blazor Data Grid component to a Blazor web app. Before proceeding, ensure that I have already added the Syncfusion Blazor Grid and Themes NuGet packages to the client-side application. Additionally, make sure that services are registered in both the server-side and client-side projects. If you want to know how to add the Syncfusion Blazor Data Grid package to a Blazor web app, check the video linked in the description below. First, I open the Home Razor component in client project, remove the default code, and define the Syncfusion Blazor Data Grid component. Then I add a code block. Inside the code block, I create the OrderModel class and add properties like OrderID, CustomerID, OrderDate, and Freight. And I set the tValue property and bind it to the order class. It indicates that the grid will display a collection of order objects. Next, I define the Syncfusion Data Manager tag and set its URL property to hold the URL of the RESTful service endpoint from which the grid will fetch data. To configure this, open the orders controller CS file and set the route attribute. This attribute specifies the route template for the controller. The OData prefix and the controller name without the controller suffix will form the URL for this controller. For example, for the orders controller, the route will be prefixed with OData and followed by orders. Before running the example, I manually update a record. I open the database data folder. And update the record. Next, I will run the OData service project alone. So I change the startup project to OData service project. Now let's run the example application. You can see the localhost page cannot be found. I set the URL path manually. Notice that the provided record is shown in the OData service project. If you want to be automatically directed to your OData and endpoint upon launching the application, open the launch settings JSON file within the OData service project and add the relative URL to open in the browser. When the project is launched, the browser will automatically navigate to this endpoint. Now, let me run the example. You can see the browser automatically navigating to this endpoint. Next, I copy the URL and paste it into the URL property. Then I add the adapter property set to OData v4 adapter, enabling the grid to interact with OData services using OData query syntax. Finally, I will run multiple projects simultaneously. I click the drop-down of the Run button and select Configure Startup Project. Then I enable multiple startup projects and set the start action for both the server and OData service projects. Notice that the startup projects are changed to multiple projects. Now let's run the example application. Notice that the home page rendered with the data grid displaying the manually provided record. Also, see the OData service project shows the provided record. Next, I will show you how to perform CRUD operations. To do this, I define the grid edit settings tag and set the allow adding, allow editing, and allow deleting properties to true. Then I add the toolbar property to display the toolbar with options like add, edit, delete, cancel, and update. Then I add the grid columns tag and set the four grid columns named order ID, customer ID, order date, and freight. Notice that the isPrimaryKey property is set to true in the order ID column. This property marks the column as the primary key for the grid's data. Now I will add the records and dynamically update the database. To do this, open the orders controller class. Inside the class, set the enable query attribute. This attribute allows the endpoint to support OData query options such as filtering, sorting, and paging on the return data. Then create a public asynchronous method named post. This method handles HTTP post requests and returns an iAction result, which is a standard return type for ASP.NET Core controller actions. The orders object is obtained from the request body as a parameter. Within the method, add the order to the orders table in the database context. Then save the changes to the database to persist the new order. Finally, return a created response with the newly created order. Let's run the example application. You can see the toolbar items rendered along with the Blazor Data Grid component. Click the Add button and enter the customer name, order date, and freight. Then, click the Update button. Notice that the new record is added successfully. Next, check the OData Service project and refresh the page to see the new record. Also, check the database and refresh it. You can see the record is updated successfully. Next, I will demonstrate how to edit a record and dynamically update the database. Open the Orders Controller class. Inside the class, set the Enable Query attribute. Create a public asynchronous method named patch. This method handles HTTP patch requests and returns an IAction result, which is a standard return type for ASP.NET Core controller actions. The key of the order to update is obtained from the OData URI as a parameter. The delta object, which represents the changes to apply, is obtained from the request body. Within the method, find the existing order entity in the orders table of the database context by its key using find async. Apply the changes from the delta object to the found entity using the patch method of the delta object. Then save the changes to the database to persist the updated order. Finally, return an updated response with the updated order entity. Let's run the example application. Select the record and click the Edit button. Then I edit the customer's name. And click the Update button. Notice that the edited record is updated successfully. Next, check the OData Service project and refresh the page to see the edited record. Also, check the database and refresh it. You can see the edited record is updated successfully. Next, I will demonstrate how to delete a record and dynamically update the database. First, set the Enable Query attribute. Then create the public long method named delete. This method handles HTTP delete requests and returns a long representing the key of the deleted record. Within the method, find the existing order entity in the orders table of the database context by its key using find. Remove the order from the orders table. Then save the changes to the database to delete the record. Finally, return the key of the deleted record. Let's run the example application. Select a record and click the Delete button. Notice that the record is deleted successfully. Next, check the OData Service project and refresh the page to ensure the record is deleted. Also, check the database and refresh it. You can see that the record is no longer present. Now let me summarize what I covered in this video. I showed you how to create OData v4 service. Also add Syncfusion Blazor Data Grid component and perform CRUD operation. If you want to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can check if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.